What's up, everyone? So today I'm here with Austin, who is actually 24, who bought 7 properties in less than 18 months, just in last 18 months. And he lives in Toronto, invests in Windsor, and he does renovations and do the refinance, you know, all this burr strategy. So if you're sitting out there and thinking that I'm young, I cannot do anything like this, and most of the properties that he purchased is none of his money. So today I'm gonna show you that from him, we're gonna learn how you can do it too. So, buddy, first of all, thank you so much for your time.
Thanks so much, Aditya.
So, tell us the what's the secret sauce?
What's the secret sauce? It's just, it's not that much of a secret. I think we hear it a lot. It's just like putting a lot of time into educating yourself, hustling, and just working hard, right? Prior to when I started real estate, I didn't know anything. And that was just around August 2018. Like the MLS, a buying agent, a listing agent, that was just all over my head. I didn't know what any of those were. But then I picked up the book Rich Dad Poor Dad, which I know that's what did it for a lot of investors as well. It didn't go into any of the technicals of real estate, so I decided, like, you know what, like I need to start learning more. Watch a couple YouTube videos, watch Matt Bichet, Matt McKeever, Mike Rosehart, all those Canadian YouTubers.
You didn't watch Mike's YouTube?
No, you didn't have one at the time, buddy.
That's true.
Now I'm your most loyal subscriber. so I just watched, including Aditya's YouTube videos, so watched all of those and learned from that, right? And then made basically every mistake you can make with my first property. There are a couple of ways I feel like you can learn in real estate. The first one is, not mistake, couple of ways you can get into real estate. The first one is do it yourself. Make your own mistakes, learn from it.
Yeah.
That's what I did. I'm sure that's what you did when you started off
as well,
right? Second one is work completely for free for someone, right? I did that as well. I worked free for Mike Rosehart for a while, and then I learned from him.
That's smart.
Third one is you pay for a coach, right? So I'm paying Corey McKinnon and I'm having him coach me. So you pay to play, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Or the fourth one is you joint venture with someone, right? And then you kind of take from the expertise, learn from it, and then do your own thing after.
So first one, you be the money partner.
Yeah, exactly. And the first property, I just made every mistake you can make. I wish I knew you at the time, man. I worked with the first agent I met. And she took me for a hell of a ride, right? telling me this, that. I was like, okay, whatever. And none of that made sense to me, whatever she was saying. And she pressured me to buy a property.
Oh, man.
Ended up buying it. And then I started working ass backwards. I was like, okay, now I have this property. I'm thinking renovations are 10 grand, but I know nothing about construction. So don't know where I got that number from. and then I was like, okay, now I have this property, I got to figure out what to do. And that's when I started driving down to Windsor and building a team. Right? I suggest that be the first step. But I didn't do that. Right? And that's when I went to the wincity event. Cassidy was hosting it at the time. And I met her there, some other fantastic investors, and I asked them what contractors they use, what property managers they use, what accountants, what lawyers, and I really built the team based on a referral basis.
I really love that, you know, going down, you got to spend time. When you are starting new, if you don't have ton of money, you have to spend time in meeting the people and getting to know and asking. You have to be willing to ask. That's what I really love about you. Yeah, go ahead, sorry.
Yeah, so I built the team out there, and it was my first go at building a team, so it wasn't perfect, right? My contractor also took me on for a ride. and from that learning experience, I learned like how to vet contractors a bit more now. Now I ask contractors for first I ask investors, like, oh, like what are some contractors to use? I hear a common name, then I meet that contractor, see the projects they've done previously, right? And then to kind of walk them through, get a quote, and do that with multiple contractors. And now I found that one contractor that I'm doing business with again and again and again. And I know you do business with him. We're keeping him busy.
That's a whole concept, right?
Exactly. He's a great guy. So you got to find the right team members. So did that with the contractor. And then the next logical step is obviously to start interviewing some property managers. Again, like I asked different investors on what property management companies they use, and I did a couple of my own due diligence. I did my own due diligence as well. So if your followers are interested, like they can DM me and I can send them like the list of questions I do ask the property managers. So that's AustinJ6 on Instagram. It's my plug.
Yeah, but no, like, I'm gonna put all the information awesome. For sure. No, yeah. But honestly, like this one thing for young kids, especially not young, just like if you're an out of town buyer, you're looking out of the city that you're looking in, you gotta reach out to Austin for sure. I'm gonna share other details later, but yeah.
So the big thing with real estate investing is there's risk in real estate investing. Yeah. One of them is the property risk. So like if you're investing in the ghetto, mm-hmm. it's gonna be risk in the property.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah.
Another one of them is the tenant risk. Okay. Mm-hmm. And this is, I'm just actually gonna focus on this. The tenant risk is the biggest risk in Canadian real estate investing. Yeah. Well, particularly in Ontario, is because once you place tenants in, it becomes nearly impossible to get them out.
Yep.
And trust me, I've inherited tenants. There's a lot of upside, but it's still very frustrating,
yeah.
right, to get them out. So you want to make sure you place the right tenant. So the property manager is probably one of the most important people on your team, because you want to make sure that they place the right tenants for you as well. So once I got the property manager in place, the contractor in place, I got the agents in place, the wholesalers in place as well, then you kind of have the wheel moving, right? You have someone to funnel you deals.
Yep.
You have someone to manage the deals for you. You have someone to do the renovations for you.
Hold on there. Like, yeah. I want to know this one, because you purchased 7 properties. Is that all your money?
No, it's not all my money. The first bit was my money to build the track record. But even then, I was borrowing money from my inner circle.
Okay.
Right?
Who's that inner circle?
Mom, dad, girlfriend. Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
Because this is a key that many people forget. You can borrow from money from your parents and just use it, leverage that. And then what you did then after that?
Exactly. After that, I built a track record for myself, and I started marketing the hell out of myself. Everything's on Instagram.
Yep.
I started posting things on LinkedIn. I started hosting my own events, which is currently being rebranded. And all of that just gives more
Where
credibility.
Is that, event?
That event is going to be at Toronto.
Toronto.
It's Rise Networks. So that's real investor serving everyone network.
Yeah. I'm going to have the link in the description, because if you're in GTA, definitely you have to connect with this kid. One more question.
Yeah, sure.
Like, why did you choose Windsor? Because you're in Toronto. There are so many other cities around. Why Windsor?
So it's a funny story. And the blunt truth is, when I was starting in real estate investing, I knew a bit, not enough. So I didn't do that much research. When I bought my first property, I didn't know research pretty much. So it's the same thing. When I chose my market, I didn't do much research, which is not how you should go about doing it. This is why I said these 4 ways at the beginning, when I was alluding to earlier, those are ways that you can kind of avoid the mistakes that I've made. But I chose the market because I had about like 40 grand saved up.
Okay.
Right? I got scholarship money. I worked from grade 9 to 12 and saved every dollar. Pretty much I worked internships, and I had to borrow some money from my mom, dad, and girlfriend as well. The only market I could afford was Windsor at the time. That's the blunt truth. And the numbers made sense, right?
Yeah.
Like, real estate for me, it's not an emotional game, it's a numbers game, right?
Yeah.
Like, if it cash flows, if I could pull the money out by adding value to the property, so forced appreciation, then my money can go a long way, right? So for me, Windsor was just like, numbers made sense. I didn't do much research, but now that I did more research, It's a strong market, high population growth, low vacancy, and it's still cash flow. It's one of the few places that cash flow around Ontario as well.
And low vacancy.
Exactly, that's the most important thing, right? So with low vacancies, you can have your pick of the tenants, especially if you have a high quality product. And what I love is that when you deal with a lot of pre-World War I bungalows, like the early 1900 bungalows, there's a lot of room to add value in them.
Yeah.
And that's the perfect property to do a BRRRR. When you deal with properties that are old and have a lot of places where you can fix it up and add value, this is why I love Windsor, right? Like, every deal I've done has pretty much been a BRRRR.
So that's pretty cool. You know, what's your plans from here on for 2020?
Yeah, so the plans for 2020, my first year has been, I did not think I would achieve as much as I did in the first year as I accomplished. But for me, it was all about mindset. And now that I have my mindset in place and I hired Corey as a coach, my 2020 is going to be really focused on growing that Rise Network event to help other investors out there as well to achieve what I've achieved. And also really is to get into multifamily investing, like bigger multis, because I really want to blow my portfolio up so that obviously I hit that financial independence sooner rather than later. And a big goal of mine is also to retire my parents. So like that would be priority. That's pretty cool. And then that's if I can cool. hit that next year, that will be freaking amazing, man. But like that's the goal.
That's just, awesome. Just that's awesome.
Continue investing.
What would be the suggestion or any thoughts for the young generation, people who are like your age who are looking but have so many questions in their brain, can I pull the trigger or not?
So my suggestion is to invest in yourself. And the only way you're going to invest in yourself is by meeting other people who can help you out, by spending money and going out to different events, right? In real estate, you can't do everything alone. There are some people where they might strike lucky, but those are far and few, and you should not judge your success based off of those people because it's not replicable, right?
Exactly.
So the most replicable way is by surrounding yourself with top quality real estate investors. Pay to play.
Yeah.
Hire a coach if you need to.
100,000 times.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Right? Like, and I've done this pretty much when I was 7 months into real estate, and my growth since then has been way more than the first couple of months of the
because,
real estate investing.
I know many people who are afraid to buy the first property.
Mm-hmm.
They've been researching and learning from years and years.
Mm-hmm.
They still couldn't pull the trigger. But
when you surround yourself with the right people, they'll encourage you to pull the trigger. Yeah. I mean, like, I've hung around with Matt McKeever so many times where he just like, just fucking do it. I'm like, okay, I'll do it, right?
Exactly. Yeah.
And that's all based on who's around you.
Would you regret about your first deal? You lost, right?
Regret.
Pretty much like, do you regret it?
I lost, but I made it up because I got lucky that Windsor appreciated. But other than that, I would have lost money. What do I regret about it? Nothing. If I didn't make that deal happen, then I wouldn't have my second deal. I wouldn't have my third deal.
I love that mindset. No. Really, trust me. This is one thing that many people stuck like, I want to make money on the first deal. Come on, forget. You're starting something new. You're going to lose or you're going to...
Break even, right?
Break even, yeah. Good thing about real estate, I made ton of mistakes on my first property, but I still made profit out of it.
Real estate is very forgiving. It's the most forgiving investment ever, right? Like, you screw up this year, 10 years down the line, it will have made almost no difference on your ROI, right? It's a very forgiving asset. So just, you got to take the leap of faith.
Love that. So, that's all I have for now, but I'm going to bring you on next year again.
Awesome.
Where people can find you.
Yeah, you can find me on Instagram at Austin, AustinYeh6. I document everything on there. And pretty much if you go on Instagram and click my link there, all of my other social media
I love those articles, so what you're writing.
Oh, man, I appreciate it. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, especially the last one, financial freedom article.
Yeah. At the end of the day, it's like what I got inspired by you. So I want to now pay it forward, and I want that person to pay it forward again and again. Right?
Yeah,
that's what it's all about.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. No, that's awesome. So I'm gonna also leave his details in the descriptions. Let us know if you have any questions. Long distance and anything that you want me to elaborate in Austin's story. Maybe we'll run over specific property details.
Yeah.
Anything that you want to know, leave in the comment below. With that, thank you so much for hopping on.
Thanks, guys.